Hey guys, Ryan here. So today I'm going to be talking about my top 10 favorite anime shows for 2021. Now, all of these didn't come out in 2021. This is just my favorite anime shows of all time for the year of 2021, basically. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. So, at number 10, we got Dragon Ball Z, Kai. And this is where it all kind of started for me. Way back in preschool, I got into anime. And Dragon Ball Z was my gateway into anime. So yeah, I used to watch like Dragon Ball every day after school. That was a lot of fun. I had like the action figures. I had like Dragon Ball Z cards. I collected the DVDs, which only had like 4 episodes on each DVD, which wasn't much at the time. But now we get like lots of episodes. Like, for example, this one has 26 episodes. So that's like way more than way back in the day, basically. And yeah, I'm actually reading through Dragon Ball Z, and I'm on volume 18. And I'm reading through the whole thing for the first time. And I'm on currently the Cell arc in DBZ. And yeah, there's been like lots of plot twists and turns, and it's very exciting reading it. It's basically been like I've been experiencing it in a new way. So yeah. Yeah, as a kid I would like, you know, pretend to do Kamehameha, stuff like that. And I still have my DBZ action figures that I had as a kid. Like, I used to draw Dragon Ball Z, like I was huge into it, and I'm still a fan of DBZ and all of Dragon Ball to this day. And there's a lot of different series for Dragon Ball. The original, which is just called Dragon Ball, then there's Z, and then GT, and then Dragon Ball Super, which is the latest one. And yeah, there's like a bunch of movies for it. And yeah, with DBZ Kai, they cut down the filler, and it's just all action, and it's been remastered in HD widescreen. So yeah, great stuff for sure. All right, next up we got is Food Wars. And yeah, I love this series. I own the limited edition box sets for seasons 1 and 2, which I have up on my shelf on the very top. So in this, there's this kid named Soma, and he goes to this elite cooking school, and it's very entertaining. There's this thing called a Shokugeki, where students can challenge each other through cooking, and like they could get expelled or have their cooking tools taken away. Stuff like that. So it's like really exciting, and the food is very unique and appetizing. And yeah, I love the limited edition box sets that I got for Food Wars, because it came with a lot of cool extra stuff, like an apron and yeah, like chopsticks, stuff like that, pins, all that kind of stuff. And yeah, we have the whole show fully animated. There's 5 seasons in total. I believe there is 36 volumes for the manga. So yeah, I love seeing the character development in this, especially of Erina. She starts off way different in the beginning of the show compared to the end. I remember one funny part was when Soma was at the school assembly and he was just like, I'm gonna be number one, I'm gonna beat everyone here. And then everyone's just like, boo, which is kind of funny. So yeah, very entertaining show. I'd love to own the rest of it. I'll definitely look into it, because I have the first 2 seasons, so might as well get the others. So yeah. Next up we got is Cowboy Bebop. So this is a classic from the 90s. I love the opening for this. The animation has done really well, and it was kind of interesting with this was, basically, there wasn't a manga for it in the first place. It was just an anime, and then a manga was made afterwards, which wasn't as good. But yeah, this is great. There's a movie for it. I haven't seen the movie. I definitely should. And yeah, this has like a very cool, stylish feel to it. It has lovable characters. The music's great. The action's cool. It's really cool. It's like cowboys in space, And yeah, the opening for it is like one of the best openings for anime, if not the best, in my opinion. So yeah, that's Cowboy Bebop. Alright, so next up we got is Demon Slayer. And yeah, there's going to be two seasons in total for this. There's a movie, which did really well at the box office. So that's awesome. And Tanjiro and Nezuko are great. I need to watch, you know, the rest of season one. And yeah, I have the first half, which I've seen so far. And yeah, it's like very intense, action-packed. And it would definitely be cool to see the movie. I haven't seen it yet. So yeah, that's Demon Slayer. Next up we got is Bleach. So we just got a new trailer for the next season of the anime for the Thousand Blood Year War arc. And that looks dope. Like seeing it in like 2021 animation is so good. The art is fantastic and it really translates well to the show for Bleach. And this used to be my number one favorite show in like fourth grade. And yeah, I absolutely love it. The action is awesome. It has really cool fights. Ichigo is a really cool character. Rukia is my favorite character in Bleach. And yeah, there's like movies for Bleach. We're getting a new season for the anime. We got a spin-off manga called Burn the Witch. And yeah, the Soul Society arc is fantastic. And I can't wait to watch and read the rest of Bleach. So far, I only have the first manga box set and the first 5 sets for the Blu-ray for Bleach. So yeah. Next up we got is Noragami. I love Noragami. It's so funny. I love the characters, the world, the story that it's telling with all these gods clashing at times. Yukine, Hiyori, Yato, the main character, they're all great. And season 2 is even better than season 1. Can't wait to get a season 3 eventually. That'll be awesome. And yeah, I have nothing but good things to say about Noragami. And I really enjoyed the first and second season. And I own the manga for it too. The art is great. It's funny. Has great lovable characters. And it's just fantastic. Alright, so next up we got is My Hero Academia. So there's been like 3 movies for this. I've seen the first 2. I've seen a lot of the anime. It has a big, diverse cast. The powers are cool. The villains are menacing. It's fantastic. And yeah, it's just a great superhero story. And it's really popular for a reason. So is Demon Slayer. And yeah, I have like nothing but good things to say about this series. It's great. I own the manga for it. And I hear that we're getting closer to the end of My Hero. Like there's 1 year left or so of the story. So yeah, I can't wait to experience all of that for sure. Alright, now we're on to my top 3 favorite anime shows. So we got Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. I love the openings for this. The story is awesome from start to finish. There's like no filler at all. The openings are great. The storytelling is awesome. And the world building makes it feel like a real place that you could travel to. The alchemy powers are really cool. And this is the second anime for Fullmetal Alchemist. And this is like the better version, I feel like. And yeah, there's so many great characters. You know, like Mustang, Winry, to name a few. And Ednell, of course. It's great. There's a spin-off movie for Fullmetal Alchemist called, like, I think The Sacred Star of Milos, I believe. So yeah, it's just a great story, and I absolutely love it, and it definitely deserves to be in my top 3 favorite anime shows. Next up we got is Haikyuu, and I don't own this on Blu-ray, but I definitely would love to, and I want to collect the rest of the manga because it just ended pretty recently. So yeah, this has great character development, it has heart, it's inspiring, it's action-packed, it's funny, It is amazing. It's so close to being my number one favorite anime. So yeah, Hinata is a great main character. He's very inspired and a hard worker. And yeah, the action's cool. I'll show some panels from the manga right there. And yeah, hopefully we get a fifth season. I'm pretty sure we will. So yeah, hopefully we get all the content that's been in the manga that's not in the anime yet animated into new seasons. That'll be great. Alright, moving on to number one, we got is Hunter x Hunter. So, I own all of Hunter x Hunter. I've seen it all. I own the manga. And yeah, this is amazing. There's like over 100 episodes. And it's just fantastic. I love all the characters. The main character, you know, he has really good ambitions and dreams to like find his dad, become a pro hunter. And there's so many great arcs, like the video game arc, the Chimera Ant arc, the Phantom Troop arc, and the story and the writing is amazing. So, yeah. That's it for my top 10 favorite anime shows for 2021. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and until next time, peace.